feet.
Oh, a pair of socks, you rogue.
Yeah, the baggage, the sleighs and all rogues. Look in the chronicles, we came in with Richard Conqueror. Therefore, Parker's Palabras led the world slide, sisters.
You will not pay for the glasses you have burst.
No, not a denny. Go, Bison Geronimo, go to thy cold bed and warm thee.
I know my remedy. I must go fetch the headborough.
Third, fourth, and fifth burner, I'll answer him by lore. I'll not budge an inch, boy. I'll let him come and kindly.
Huntsman, I charge thee, tender well my hounds. Brack Merriman, the poor cur, is embossed, and couple Chowder with the deep mouth Brack. Sawst thou not, boy, how Silver made it go to the hedge corner in the coldest fault? I would not lose the dog for £20.
Why, Bellman is as good as he, my lord. He cried upon it at the merest loss, and twice today picked out the dullest scent. Trust me, I take him for the better dog.
Thou art a fool. If Echo were as fleet, I would esteem him worth a dozen such. But sup them well, and look unto them all. Tomorrow I intend to hunt again.
I will, my lord.
What's here? One dead? Or drunk? See, doth he breathe?
Oh, he breathes, my lord. Were he not warmed with ale, this were a bed but cold to sleep so soundly.
Oh, monstrous beast. How like a swine he lies. Grim death, how foul and loathsome is thine image. Sirs, I will practice on this drunken man. What think you if he were conveyed to bed wrapped in sweet clothes? Rings put upon his fingers, a most delicious banquet by his bed, and brave attendants near him when he wakes. Would not the beggar then forget himself?
Believe me, Lord, I think he cannot choose.
It would seem strange unto him when he waked.
Even as a flattering dream or worthless fancy. Then take him up and manage well the jest. Carry him gently to my fairest chamber and hang it round with all my wanton pictures. Balm his foul head in warm distilled waters and burn sweet wood to make the lodging sweet. Procure me music ready when he wakes to make a dulcet and a heavenly sound. And if he chance to speak, be ready straight and with a low, submissive reverence say, what is your honour will command? Let one attend him with a silver basin full of rose water and bestrewed with flowers. Another bear the ewer, the third a diaper. And say, will to please your lordship cool your hat? Someone be ready with a costly suit and ask him what apparel he will wear. Another tell him of his hounds and horse and that his lady mourns at his deceit. Persuade him that he hath been a lunatic. And when he says he is, say that he dreams, for he is nothing but a mighty lord. This do, and do it kindly, gentle sirs. It will be pastime passing excellent if it be husbanded with modesty.
My lord, I warrant you we will play our part as he shall think by our true diligence he is no less than what we say he is.
Take him up gently and to bed with him, and each one to his office when he wakes.
Come, come.
Sirrah, go see what trumpet is that sounds. Belike some noble gentleman that means travelling some journey to repose him here. Hello? Who is it?
And please, your honour, players that offer service to your lordship.
Bid them come near. Now, fellows, you are welcome.
Oh, we thank your honour.
Do you intend to stay with me tonight?
So please your lordship to accept our duty?
With all my heart. This fellow I remember, since once he played a farmer's eldest son. 'Twas where you wooed the gentlewoman so well. I forgot your name. But sure, that part was aptly fitted and naturally performed.
I think 'twas Soto that your honour means.
'Tis very true. Thou didst it excellent. Well, you are come to me in happy time. The rather, for I have some sport in hand, wherein your cunning can assist me much. There is a lord will hear you play tonight. But I am doubtful of your modesties, lest, overeyeing of his odd behaviour, for yet his honour never heard a play, you break into some merry passion and so offend him. For I tell you, sirs, if you should smile, he grows impatient.
Fear not, my lord. We can contain ourselves, were he the veriest antic in the world.
Go, sirrah, take them to the battery. And give them friendly welcome, everyone. Let them want nothing that my house affords. Sirrah, go you to Bartholomew, my page, and see him dressed in all suits like a lady. That done, conduct him to the drunkard's chamber and call him madam. Do him obeisance. Tell him from me, as he will win my love, he bear himself with honorable action, such as he hath observed in noble ladies unto their lords by them accomplished. Such duty to the drunkard let him do, with soft, low tongue and lowly courtesy, and say, what is your honour will command, wherein your lady and your humble wife may show her duty and make known her love? And then, with kind embracements, tempting kisses, and with declining head into his bosom, bid him shed tears, as being overjoyed to see her noble lord restored to health, who for this 7 years hath esteemed him no better than a poor and loathsome beggar. And if the boy have not a woman's gift to rain a shower of commanded tears, an onion will do well for such a shift, which in a napkin, being close conveyed, shall in despite enforce a watery eye. See this dispatch with all the haste thou canst, and on I'll give thee more instructions. I know the boy will well usurp the grace, voice, gait, and action of a gentlewoman. I long to hear him call the drunkard husband. And how my men will stay themselves from laughter when they do homage to this simple peasant. I'll intercounsel them. Haply my presence may well abate the over-merry spleen, which otherwise would grow into extremes.
For God's sake, a pot of small ale.
Will please your lordship drink a cup of sack?
Will please your honour taste of these conserves?
What raiment will your honour wear today?
I am Christopher O'Sly. Call me not honour nor lordship. I ne'er drank sack in my life. And if you give me any conserves, give me conserves of beef. Ne'er ask me what raiment I'll wear, for I have no more doublets than backs, no more stockings than legs, nor no more shoes than feet, nay, sometime more feet than shoes, or such shoes as my toes look through the overleather.
Heaven cease this idle humour in your honour. Oh, that a mighty man of such descent, of such possessions and so high esteem, should be infused with so foul a spirit.
What would you make me mad? Am I not Christopher Sly, old Sly, son of Burton Heath, by birth a peddler, by education a card maker, by transportation a bearer, and now by present profession a tinker? Ask Marion Hackett, the fat ale wife of Winkard, if she knows me not. If she say I have not 14 pence on the score for share, I'll score me up for the lyingest knave in Christendom. What, I am not bestraught. Yes.
Oh, this it is that makes your lady moan.
Oh, this it is that makes your servants droop.
Hence comes it that your kindred shuns your house, as beaten hence by your strange lunacy. Oh, noble lord, bethink thee of thy birth. Call home thy ancient thoughts from banishment, and banish hence these abject, lowly dreams. Look how thy servants do attend on thee, each in his office ready at thy beck. Wilt thou have music? Hark, Apollo plays, and 20 caged nightingales do sing. Or wilt thou sleep? We'll have thee to a couch softer and sweeter than the lustful bed on purpose trimmed up for Sir Mirimis. Say thou wilt walk, we will bestrew the ground. Or wilt thou ride? Thy horses shall be trapped, their harness studded all with gold and pearl. Dost thou love hawking? Thou hast hawks, will soar above the morning lark. Or wilt thou hunt? Thy hounds shall make the welkin answer them, and fetch shrill echoes from the hollow earth.
Say thou wilt course. Thy greyhounds are as swift as breathed stags, aye, fleeter than the roe.
Dost thou love pictures? We will fetch thee straight Adonis, painted by a running brook, and Cytherea all in sedges hid, which seem to move and wanton with her breath, even as the waving sedges play with wind.
We'll show thee Io as she was a maid, and how she was beguiled and surprised, as lively painted as the deed was done.
Or Daphne roaming through a thorny wood, scratching her legs, that one shall swear she bleeds, and at that sight shall sad Apollo weep, so workmanly the blood and tears are drawn.
Thou art a lord and nothing but a lord. Thou hast a lady, far more beautiful than any woman in this waning age.
And till the tears that she hath shed for thee, like envious floods, o'errun her lovely face, she was the fairest creature in the world, and yet she is inferior to none.
Am I a lord? Have I such a lady? Or do I dream? Or have I dreamed to know? I do not sleep. I see, I hear, I speak. I smell sweet savours and I feel soft things. Upon my life, I am a lord indeed, and not a tinker, not Christopher Sly. Well, bring our lady hither to her sight, and once again, a perch of the smallest ale.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.